There was a time when we didn't have Excel, and then Bricklin and Frankston, they said, I want a visual calculator. And here's what they said. Equal sign, that means we're doing a formula. I'm going to take the sales, and notice I clicked on D3. That means whatever I put in that cell, this formula will update, times the commission rate. And not only did they think of referring to a cell so we can change it, but they said, guess what? If I want to copy this down, I need this blue one to move boop, 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 boop. As I copy down as a relative cell reference, I need this locked. So we can hit the F4 key, as long as it's touching, and the dancing ants are going around the cell that we're touching, F4. It puts the dollar signs in. Those are arbitrary symbols that say, hey, throughout the copy action, I am not going to move. Double click with our angry rabbit. That's a crosshair. Double click. Send it down. Go to the last cell, F2. And sure enough, blue moved all the way down. Orange one locked. So for 40 years, we had this amazing relative and absolute cell reference. And then guess what? Microsoft hired this guy named Joe McDaid. And he said, you know what? There's an easier way, and it will help array calculations. He said, instead of equals clicking on a single cell, just highlight all the relative cell references. That means all the values that we want to reference as we copy down, times the commission rate. We don't have to lock it, control enter. We don't have to manually copy it down. And later, if we want to come and edit, we just, like adding the round function, we just edit in the top cell. And unlike the old days, we don't have to recopy it down. It just shoots down, and the entire column is filled with that new formula. And who do we get to thank? We get to thank Bricklin and Frankston and Joe McDaid. All right, Excel and dynamic spilled formulas, efficiency, power, and fun.